for some reason, your joysticks on your Xbox just don't work. Now, as I mentioned before, this happens a lot of the time, either this joystick or this joystick, and this is specifically for the Xbox One controller, but again, this can probably be transferred over to any other Xbox controller as well. So typically the first thing that I would recommend doing if your joysticks are just not working is literally one of the easiest things you can do, and I do this all the time. What you want to do is find your specific joystick that's causing the issue. You want to go ahead and post it over to the right side and kind of turn it around a little bit on each side for just a little bit of time. And you also want to do it for the other one as well. And then what you want to do, it sounds crazy, is either get a can of air or you can also blow on your specific controller as well. And what you want to do is you want to push your controller to one side, basically creating a little bit of a gap here. And all you want to do is blow extremely hard in this specific corner. So you would essentially want to go and blow in this corner right here. Then what you want to do is put your controller up and then do the exact same thing on this specific controller as well. You want to blow right here. And if you have a can of air, like I said, it might be a little bit better. But you essentially want to do the same thing there. You then want to go ahead and put the control on this side as well. Blow here and then blow here. Same exact thing. And then you essentially want to go ahead and turn the controller, the joystick around just a couple of directions each way. And you essentially want to do the exact same thing on this side of your controller as well. Now, for those of you who don't know, basically there can be a lot of dust and just a bunch of that random stuff built up in your controller over time. So the best thing to do in this case, as I mentioned before, is to essentially blow on your controller as hard as you can and then clean out your controller that way. That can remove a lot of that dust and debris and can essentially make your joysticks functional again. If you don't feel comfortable blowing on it, you don't think you can work on it, then go ahead and get a can of air. But essentially blowing on it may actually end up fixing the issue in and of itself. So that's the way to do it for free. Now, as long as your controller isn't extremely messed up and, you know, it doesn't actually have a physical defect,